Hello, everybody. Dr. Darok here, and welcome back to Let's Play Mindscape, the showcase Let's Play for my mod pack, which you guys are the early testers of. And thank you all for playing, those of you who have. I've gotten over 300 downloads so far of the mod pack, and that's just among those of you who are watching this series. So I very much appreciate your early testing. I just wanted to lead off this video by saying that yes, I do plan to continue updating it. For now, the final version, or at least final version before I publicly release it to everyone, is going to be version 2.0. So whenever you see that there's an update for version 2.0, just make sure you back up your world beforehand, because there might be a little bit of a transition. There might be a few transitional bugs involved going from an older version up to that version. So I'm still working on this, but for now, this is just me doing a Let's Play, and basically I am gambling that there's not going to be enough changes to totally break it so that I can continue the same Let's Play world despite the changes and upgrades and things. So thanks so much, and let's get started. So today, rather than doing more quests in the quest book, although we might get around to one or two of these, what we're going to do is actually let me think. What do I want to say? We're going to move our operation into Gilanor. So rather than having a base here in the overworld, I'm actually going to go to the world of RuneScape, and we're going to build a base there. And I have iron in here, don't I? Yes. Quite a lot of iron. Very good. Okay, hold on. Let me just do this and put these things in here. Take this out. Whoops. There we are. And let's get some iron real quick. I'm in need of this for purposes. So I'm going to grab this. We're going to go to Gilanor. We're going to start building a base there. Now, I'm thinking that the majority of the base itself... What are you doing over there? I'm thinking that the majority of the base itself is actually going to be underground, with, you know, like something showing above the ground, but most of it is going to be underground. That's just what I'm thinking for now, although that is liable to change. I may, after I build the initial thing, I may build it up several floors from what I start with. So, I mean, I guess you never know, but yeah. So, I've made a little bit of extra iron here. I'm gonna leave that right in here for now. How about that? There we go. Oh, I've got plenty of iron, haven't I? So, we're just gonna head straight to Gilanor, and I'm gonna show you guys what I've packed and what I'm bringing so far. So, here we go. The teleportation is happening now! Okay. And here in Gilanor, you'll know that things are good, things are great. So, and I am going to base the location of my house right around my portal here, so that I don't have any issues finding it in the future. Basically, we're gonna start a farm and things. It's gonna be great. So, here's what I want to do first. I want to take, I don't know if I have that much. How much wood planks is that going to make? 33. That's not a very big house. So I guess I'm going to use something else for the floor, and that something else is going to be stone bricks. So let's just go ahead and make a couple stacks of stone bricks here, just like this. There we are. And I'm probably going to use that for the walls as well. I know that can be a little dull, just stone bricks everywhere. But hey, you know, you got to start somewhere, right? So I think I'm going to go out to, like, let's see here. We want maybe, like, I guess 8 by 13 is a little big, isn't it? Let's just go with, how many is this? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I don't really have, like, a schematic for what I'm going to build. Let's see, what is that? 8 by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 8 by 6. Well, that's not bad. Could be better, could be worse. So that's what we're going to start with, though. So, yeah. Let's go ahead and just build this. like that. And then I'm going to build this back wall first. Wall off my portal. And actually, I guess I don't need the corners here, do I? So let's cut out the corners. Yeah. Yeah. There we go. And yeah. And yeah. There we go. Save myself a little bit of material in the process there. Let's see here. Build up to at least there to cover my portal. Just like this. Boom. And we're just going to keep building. So, yeah, and I know that maybe building isn't always the most exciting topic for an episode, but it is, basically, it's about time that I built some stuff in this world. So, and made myself an actual base, as opposed to just, like, coming here and then doing something and then fleeing, like a scared puppy dog or whatever, what have you. So, yeah, and I don't necessarily... There's a cobblestone here. To demonstrate during the live stream the right-click capacity of Tinker's Construct tools to place blocks and things. That was actually a good demonstration. Let's see here. So what about my... you know what? I'm going to want to change the way that this is laid out. I might want some... let's see here. Let's get some sticks like this. We're going to make a crafting table, but then we're going to turn it into a crafting station, which we're then going to remove the legs from, just like so. I'm going to place this in this corner right here. That way I have something that I can craft stuff with. Let's craft a little bit of ladder. We don't need too much, but a little bit is going to be necessary. I've got cobblestone on me somewhere in, like, here. Yes. Okay. So, just like that, I'm going to put a cobblestone there, and yeah, I guess I'm going to come down here and do like this, and like maybe one here. Yeah, there we go, that should be good enough, and that will go down into the mine, just like so. Eh. Come on. There we are. Okay, perfect. And it's getting dark already. Oh my. So why don't I head back? We're gonna take a nap in my bed real quick, and then we're actually going to pick it up and take it back with us. So, yes. I am moving my respawn location as well over to the Gillenor world. Oh, okay. Bleh. Get rid of those. Pick up the bed. Okay, and here we are. So, yeah, this is one thing that I'm definitely going to do is move my bed here. We're going to go with, let's see here. That's a tall enough roof, I suppose. We're going to put the bed right there, and that still doesn't give me enough room to jump up on this. Okay, let's, yeah, there we go. That works. Whatever works. And we're just gonna build a couple layers of this tiny, tiny building here. But it is my tiny building. So, you know, hey, anything that you build is good enough for you, right? It's enough to make you happy. I'm just gonna make like a flat roof, I think. No need to make anything fancy. And in fact, I think I'm gonna leave this dense cobblestone showing through the roof. I don't really care about that. Mainly I just want, I'm more about function than form. That's all there is to it. However, I am getting low on the stone. So, something that we're gonna wanna do, and quick, is, increase the number of, the amount of stone that I have. I am gonna need it for other purposes too. So, yeah, there we go. Okay, that should be good for now. Oh, hey, look, I've got one more. Huh. Wonderful. So, let's do this. I'm going to place a cobblestone there and there. And, yeah, I almost forgot something that I really want to do, which is put torches on the roof so that I don't have monsters spawning above me. Yes. So, let's pick this stuff back up and head back through here. And we're going to do something... Hello? Did I just take damage? Okay, well, let's eat a taco. Yum, num, 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 num. Okay, so we're going to do something to resolve the issue with not having stone. So first of all, I'm going to take some cobblestone from here, and we're going to pop it in the furnace while we wait for other things to happen. Oh yeah, also, I've made some rune bars here, which I'm going to want to take a stick and two rune bars, and you'll see the rune longsword has 34 attack damage, which is significantly better than my mithril matic, so that is my new weapon of choice. Okay, so yeah, for the time being, let's get rid of this dirt. I don't need that. All right, just great. And, ow, jerk, invisible jerks, I don't understand that, I just don't get it, something weird happens that makes invisible things come to life and attack me. Oh yeah, I wanted to be over here, actually. So, here's what I want to do. I want to make an item called a dolly, M-dollyte, dolly. There we go. And this will allow me to easily move storage containers. So what we're going to need is uno blocco of the planks, which I shall place right here. And five iron ingots? Five iron ingots. Yeah, there we go. Okay, so boom, shakalaka. Let's do iron ingots here. And now I've created a dolly. And so what we're going to do is take this dolly and we're going to right-click this better barrel with the dolly. And that will place the barrel on the dolly. And then I am able to place the barrel back down, let's say here, for example. Who do you think you are? What just happened? How did it even die? I don't even know how that thing died. I don't have, like, thorns or anything, do I? I didn't attack it. Did I attack that thing? I'm confused now. Now I'm highly confused. Get away from me, you! Jeez Louise. Okay. Well, that was fun and all, but yeah. So I'm coming back over here to get more stone and thus make more, stone bricks. Whoops. Which I'm going to need in order to proceed with the building of my place. So let's just do this. There we go. And stone bricks. Okay. So yeah. Really? Get away from me. See, I can't even hit it, though. That's the thing that really gets me. Whatever. And I think it's just like imps. Imps in the RuneScape world can attack me through, like, transdimensionally, which I find to be highly bizarre. See? And they're very rude about it, too. But hey, whatever. I'm not here to complain. I'm just here to build. So we're going to fill in this roof now, so that I'm not under constant assault, perhaps. Although I doubt that'll fix the problem. Place some torches so that it's lit. Okay, and now we've got a decent base. Oh, wait. You know what? Oh, no. Never mind. Well, there's something else that I want to do, but I don't know if I'm going to do it this episode. I mean, I've got to, actually, to be interesting. It's going to be interesting. You guys are going to like this, I think. So, yeah. As far as other things go, there are a few things that I need to do. I'm going to stuff some stuff in my bag of holding here because I'm not currently using it. Let's see here. Oh, you know what? There's something I want to test, though, and that's going to require me to take out some stone. Here's what I want to do. I want to take this stone, and I have books somewhere. Where are the books? Books, 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 books. I don't see them. Am I staring straight past them? I know I've got books. In here? No. In here? No. In here? No. Okay, now I know I've got books. That's something that I know for a fact. I just had them. I was just putting them in... Where are they? Okay, guys, please tell me I'm blind and I just don't see the books because I thought they were right here. Oh, they're in my inventory. Ah, dummy. Okay, so I'm going to take some stone like this in a furnace shape and place a book in the center, and that will create mind runes. So with mind runes and fire runes, I should be able to use the fire staff, I think. Yes, I can. So I can now use my fire staff, and it shoots fire, and it's pretty awesome. Although, actually, I didn't use the mind runes. Now, I swear that during my live stream or one of my previous episodes, I tried using the fire staff, and I couldn't, even with fire runes. So I'm a little confused about that. But as you can see, fire staff is maybe not effective at all. It's maybe the weakest thing in the world. It does catch things on fire. Jeb was burnt to a crisp while fighting Dr. Darok. Take that, Jeb! Wonderful. Okay, so here's what I'm going to do. We're going to move on and go on to the next thing. I don't even really want this, so let's just put it back in here along with these runes and stuff. I don't know what the mind runes are good for. I guess they're good for this, which is cool. Monster Examine Book with Astral Runes, Mind Runes. So yeah. Oh, you know what? I have glowstone dust, don't I? Somewhere sitting in one of these chests. One single uno de glowstone dust. Okay, well, you win some, you lose some, I guess. Alright, so, here's what we're gonna do. I am going to, we're gonna grab some stuff here that we need. I want to have a farm. I want everything to be enclosed, so that's gonna be a little tricky. But I don't think it's gonna be that tricky, so I'm gonna just, like, dump as much of this stuff as I can that I don't need right now. Here we are. Let's see here. The pot and the juicer. Let's put these back in here. Don't need them right now. Although, actually, let me take this juicer. And I've got some berries somewhere. Let's see here. Like, in here? Yes. So I'm going to take this juicer and these raspberries, and I'm going to make raspberry juice. And that is much better than the berries themselves. It's 2.5 hunger shanks of hunger, so that's a rather effective food, and we're gonna have that for lunch or what have you whenever I get hungry. The next thing that we're going to want to do is, I guess, make a new tool, and this is gonna be, this is tricky. I'm not really sure what tool I want to make, but I guess, well, let's just take some gold ore here and some iron ore, and let's see here. So, none of this stuff. Oh, look, I've still got aluminum brass here, so I guess I don't need the gold. And what I'm going to do is, let's see here. First, I want to make a stencil for the broad axe head, a stencil for the tough binding, stencil for the large plate, a stencil for the tough rod. So those are some of the things that we're going to start with here. And you know what? Let me just get some more of this junk out of my inventory so I've got space to work with here. Like this juicer goes back in there, for example. I guess I can place the dolly. Does this go on the tool rack? Whoops! No, it picks up the tool rack. Oh my. Yeah, so why don't I just put it up here. There we go. That's more like it. And it is dark. So now I don't have bed powers. Let's go ahead and... I guess I should maintain an overworld bed. So let's make another one. There we are. Just in case I happen to be in a situation where I'm here in the overworld. And it's raining now, which makes my timing just perfect. Because as far as I understand it, sleeping in a bed completely clears rain. So there we go. No more rain. Rain should go away. Rain, go away. Come again another day. Whatever, etc., etc. Oh, you know what? I just thought about something. Since it's a new day, I can now claim another piece of night metal. Here we go. That's wonderful. And I am storing that in here for now. I've got to get to 8 of these. So I'm at 3 so far. Hopefully in 10 days, I should be able to get it. So or 5 more days, actually, I suppose, Minecraft days, which isn't that bad. And you know what? I want to bring this with me, because if I click with this, shift-right-click? Yeah, there we go. If I shift-right-click this on open air, it does this. If I shift-right-click it, or if I just right-click it on blocks somewhere, it just produces cobblestone. So, free cobblestone forever, for life, which is pretty cool. So, that is something that I wanted to point out. Let's see here. I was doing something. Oh, yeah, right. I was in the process of doing this. So, I've got a couple quests here that we're going to get done in the process. Excavate this is just make these several casts here. I'm a lumberjack and I'm okay. Hammer time and cleave me alone. So that's what we're going to do. I'm going to make these, I'm going to make all of those, necessary, casts in order to move on. So we're also going to make a hammerhead pattern and an excavator pattern, just like this. Now, I haven't got enough metal. How many is that? That is 7. Ah, perfect, which is exact. Oh, I just lost the game. By the way, in case you don't know what the game is, you lose the game every time you think about the game. And now you're playing, because I've told you about it. You can't quit. And the number 7 makes me lose the game. So now that I've told you that you've lost the game, and I've explained to you what the game is, you've all just lost the game. Thank you so much for playing. And, yeah. Basically, there's supposed to be, like, a cooldown. Like, some people say, you know, hey, if you lose the game, you can't lose for 20 minutes so that you have time to forget about it or whatever. And then next time you think about the game, you lose again. So, yeah, the object is to not think about the game, but there's no way to win. All you can do is avoid losing. So, anyways, I'm going to take some random material, such as the cobblestones, which are, let's just, rather than heading into the other world to get some cobblestones, why don't we just go down here and just, like, mine a little bit of the cobblestones. Because I do want to upgrade this pickaxe anyways. I want to level it up. So, yeah, here we go. We're going to mine a little bit of the cobblestones. And I'm going to need less than a stack. But a stack is a good number to aim for. So let's go for, like, why? I can't right-click my torch. I can't do the right-clickety. I don't understand. That's weird. That should work, but it's not. Oh, well. I guess I'll just have to live with it. So, yes. Let's see here. That is almost a stack. That's good enough. 56. Pretty good number. So, moving on from there, we're going to make some stone versions of all these different tool parts, and then we're going to go cast them. So, let's see here. First, let's do a hammer head. So, stone hammer head. And then large blade. All right. And then tough binding. Perfect. Okay. Broad axe head. Just like this. Put it back. Excavator. Okay. Tough rod. And finally the large plate. There we go. So that's quite a lot of material there that we need in order to do all this stuff. But that's okay because it's well worth it. So, here I go. I'm going to put this casting basin away. And let's place a casting table down. And I will put first my stone hammerhead. And that only uses one ingot of aluminum brass. Then the large sword blade, just like this. All right, perfect. And the excavator head. There we go. Marvelous. And the tough binding. All right, fantastic. Come on, there we go. The stone tough rod. And then the stone large plate. There. And finally, the stone broad axe head. Perfect. So now I should have 4 quests complete. Yay! So I've completed this quest, which is called Hammer Time. I get 10 White Knight favor, chance cube, reward bag. So I got some free reward bags, some free chance cubes from doing that. Pretty cool stuff. Excuse me. Sorry about that. As you can see, I got two good, one greater, one basic. So let's go ahead and open some reward bags here as soon as I place these in my chest to free up some inventory space. There we go. So basic reward bag gives me two Manichio blocks. Oh, that's cool. Actually, I really like that reward. It's a great reward. And then we've got two good reward bags, Ghostwood Sapling, and luggage. Ooh, hello. A different kind of familiar. Hello, luggage. How are you? Are you having a wonderful day, Mr. Luggage? Great. I'm glad to hear it. So luggage is pretty cool. It's from the Open Blocks mod, and if there are items on the ground, it goes and noms them. It noms your items, and actually, it sometimes makes a nom 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 sound as it does so. So, as you can tell, it's munching them items, which is pretty cool. I always thought that that was, like, super cool. So, yeah. Let's see here. I'm going to put some iron ore in my smeltery, and yes, I know, I am still using it as a storage. I don't want to get rid of these things. I guess I could make the bronze into ingots, but this other stuff I can't really. So, sorry about that for anyone who has the OCDs about things like that. Also, I may need to go pick up some more lavas. So, let's just head down into my mining area, and luggage should teleport to me if I get far enough away, and is also completely invincible and immortal. So pretty cool stuff there. And oh, hello, how are you? Okay, so I am going to head down this way. Where am I? Did I use a chance cube on that, or the chance cube scanner on that? Did I check what it was? I think so. I think it was like -7 or something. So, or 12 or what have you. But I didn't want to do it either way. It was basically the outcome of said testing. So let's see here. I know that my lava pool is up here. So let's get up here and, oh hey, look, there's still water here. I'm just going to fill a couple buckets with lava. And then let's use the Ophanix here and fill in the gaps. I guess I can't. I guess it doesn't work like that. Oh my, I almost walked right into the lava. I guess it doesn't quite work like that. But I have got... Nope! Don't have any cobblestones whatsoever. So that's unfortunate. But oh well, let's just move on. So yeah, with lavas, I should be able to power my smeltery for quite some time yet. So, I needn't worry about my smeltery ceasing function. And we're just going to have to, I don't know, see what we're doing next. Cause I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to make these, I'm going to make some of these tools completely out of iron. And then we are going to upgrade them at a later date. Although I think the hammer I might make completely out of mithril. Or at least make the hammer head out of mithril. Or, you know what, I've got quite a lot of mithril. But I really wanted to hit that 30. Although 4 for the hammer head. And then, let's see here, let's do 3. That'll make 2 tough rods. Okay, yeah, there we go. So let's do that. That's perfect. So, yes, as you can see, it did manage to smelt my iron, but it just perfectly ran out of lava right at the moment that it finished somehow. I don't know. Don't ask me for specifics on exactly how such a coinkydink could occur. But anyways, there's more iron going in. So let's see here. If I want a lumber axe, an excavator, and a hammer, then I'm going to need several large plates. So let's start with those. And you know what? In fact, do I have aluminum? Have I got the aluminums? I've got some aluminum. Ah, there's aluminum. Yes. In fact, I can take some aluminum and some obsidian and combine it with my iron to make alumite, which is another rather good metal. So let's see here. Aluminum. Where's the smelting? There we go. Then alloys. Alumite. That is, what is this? Doing math. So 3 times that is 96. That's 80. So this is 2, 2, and 5 to make 3. So, yeah. Okay, so that means I've got 3 obsidian. So if I take 3 obsidian and let's see here. 15. There we go. Okay, just great. So I'm going to put the obsidian in here and some aluminum. We're going to do that. We're going to let it... Hello, color-changing Disco Jeb. What are you up to, Mr. Sheep? Man, those are cool. That was a neat reward from from a chance cube. I really liked that reward. Super fun. I mean, Sheep Disco. Like, who would have come up with that? I mean, that's pretty awesome stuff. Okay, so let's eat some raspberry... Well, drink some raspberry juice? Yeah, that's how that works. I'm going to place my large plate here. As you can see, there's now molten aluminum and molten iron in here. Although, I need... What is it? More molten aluminum. Is the obsidian working? Yes, okay. It just takes quite a lot of heat and is progressing rather slowly. Oh, I see. So, yeah, you'll see that the obsidian will go in. It'll instantly alloy some alumite, but it'll leave some aluminum and obsidian as well, despite that, until I finish. Oh, somehow I've wound up with extra aluminum, but whatever. I guess that makes sense. Either way, here's what I need to do next. Let's see, combine this aluminum because I don't need it for anything. Although, can molten aluminum be used for anything else that's interesting other than alumite? I don't think so. Aluminum brass. No, that's it. Just aluminum brass or this. Now, for every one copper, I need 3 aluminum. So I can make more aluminum brass, but I don't believe that I need... like 18 ingots worth of, or 12, whatever. I don't believe I need a whole bunch of ingots worth of aluminum brass right now. Hey, Mr. Jeb. Hey, what are you doing? Hey, you know this is dangerous, right? You shouldn't walk on it like that if you want to survive. Are you okay? Luggage is immune, though, so that's fortunate. Okay, so I'm going to make... Let's see, alumite. What kind of properties does alumite have? I forget. Let's see here. Alumite. So if I press U right here. Oh yeah, I can make alumite seeds. Oh, that's cool. Of course I don't have Imperio essence yet. That's a ways off still. But still, you know, hey, that's pretty cool stuff. So let's see here. I've got mining level of ardite, attack 5 hearts. Reinforced 2. Reinforced 2 isn't bad. I might want that as one of my large plates, perhaps. It's got a handle modifier of 1.3, so I could make some decent handles with it, too. But Mithril's got a better handle modifier if we look here. Oh, yeah, you know what? I forgot to open my other reward bag. What's in here? Take a chance. Oh, thanks. Thank you. I appreciate that so much. So, let's see here. I've got 30 ingots of iron. So let's go ahead and make some iron large plates first. I'm not really sure how much of each of these I'm going to need. So that'll depend a little bit on exactly how everything turns out. And I think I'm going to take this ghostwood sapling with me. Nah, you know what? Let's just leave it here. Boom. Okay, I don't need that in Gillenor. So, yeah, let's see here. I'm going to grab, like, 2 or 3 of these, something like that. And then we are going to just make some tools. So there we go. Okay, let's see. I also want maybe a little bit more iron in here. Yeah, there we go. Okay, so let's make three of these. Then I'm going to be cooking up more iron, which is good news. And I'm also going to make an alumite large plate. Yeah, let's do it. Because I know that iron has reinforced one. So alumite's reinforced two is going to override that, make it better. Although, doesn't mithril actually have... Let's see. Mithril has reinforced two as well. Also, mining level ardite, attack 5 hearts. Handle modifier 2.5x. Makes a great handle modifier. Mithril makes amazing handles, actually. So, yeah, as soon as this iron is cooked up, I am going to put some mithril in there so that we can make other parts. Although, I think that's all the large plates I'm going to need. Well, no, actually, that's not true, because I didn't make the one out of alumite yet. So, let's do that. There we go. Perfect. Now, I don't really know that that's going to do much of anything for me, but I made it, so I might as well use it. All right, perfect. And then, let's see here. Let's also do this. I'm going to take, let's see here. We've got one ingot of alumite left. You know what? I don't really want to do that. Let's just melt that back down. I want to just, like, make alumite plants later. So, you know what? I'm gonna make that into ingots. We're just going to hold on to it for now. Or at least 4 ingots worth. So I don't have to mix up more later, or ever, actually. So that sounds like a plan to me. Which is to say, let's go ahead and make another iron large plate. And then I will switch my cast. Let's see, we're going to need one of these, one of these, one of these. And where's the hammer head? Oh, I have the hammer head. Where's the broad axe head? I have that somewhere, right? Or do I? Large blade, hammer head, excavator. Okay, I definitely need the lumber axe. I need tough rod, tough binding, ingot, axe head, broad axe. There we go. Okay. Wunderbar. Okay, so I'm going to take this molten mana infused metal here. And we're going to, let's see. First, I want to make a hammer head out of that stuff, which is wonderful. Let's do that. And as soon as that's done, I'm going to make 2 tough rods out of the stuff as well. There we go. So, tough rod number 1. There we go. And then, boom. Oops. And then tough rod number 2. And actually, at this point, I can head on in here. There goes my phone. Whoops. At this point, I can head on in here, open up my tool forge, and we can make this hammer. So, let's see here. Hammer, do this, do that. And a couple of these, just like this. Perfect. Okay, so you'll see I've got a mithril hammer, reinforced 2, mining level ardite. I'm not very skilled with it yet, but I will get over time. So yeah, let's grab this other tough rod, and let's place this in here, and we can just move on. Next thing I want is a broad axe head. There we go. This will help me with collecting the various other things in the future. Yes, quite. And let's cook some more iron in, because I'm going to need some more. There we go. And actually, you know what? I'm not going to make a large blade yet. I may in the future, but I'm not going to yet. So there's broad axe. And I will need a couple of these too. So let me, you know what? Let's just make a few of these. Perfect. And, you know, the purpose of making all these tools is basically, you know, I'm still going to have one pickaxe for Tinker's Construct for, like, single things, but I'm also going to use the hammer, like, a lot. I'm going to use that hammer to death. So, yeah, we're going to need plenty of that hammer stuff. And then I'm going to want an excavator cast as well. Let's see here. So let's do this and that and this. There we go. I think I've got everything that I need now to make the broad axe, lumber axe, whatever you want to call it. Lumber axe, yeah. So, yes, let's do this, and then this, and this, and that. Do I want to use... Which one do I want to use here? You know what? Hold on. Here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to pick this up. There we go. We can get rid of this, and this, and this, and that. But I am going to need one of these made out of iron. And I can't decide whether I want to use that for the excavator or the lumber axe, my mithril rod that I've made. So let's see here. If I put that there, that makes a full iron lumber axe. That one makes it a mithril. Big difference in durability. You know what? Yeah, let's just do that. And then, here we go. Let's make a lumber axe as well. And you know what? Most of the time I'd name these things, but, I'm trying to really keep track of what they're made out of. So, yeah, I don't think I need to do that. So, that is that. So, if you do not know what these items do yet, if you've never been introduced to, say, the lumber axe, for example, then I suppose it's time for an introductory course. Now, what does this hammer do? It's only +8 attack damage, so that's not very good. And I know this rune longsword will kill pretty much any overworld mob except for an Enderman in one hit, and an Enderman it will with a crit. So... yeah, pretty amazing stuff. There's a giant redwood tree here. So what does the lumber axe do? It just pretty much, like, blows a hole in it. Now, if it was a smaller tree than the redwood, there are other things that it could accomplish, such as with this tree here, it'll just, boom, fell the entire tree. Ow. That kind of hurt, dude. Yeah, oh, Ring of Recoil. That's what killed the imps. I forgot about that. Yeah, okay, cool. And you'll see, this is where I got these cherries from, which is cool. I collected some cherries, which is always nice. You know, you like to have a cup... Nom, 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 nom. Did you hear him? Yeah, he's pretty funny. He makes pretty funny sounds, I'll tell you that much. What about these arrows? You gonna pick these up? Do you have room for those? Yeah, pick up these arrows, dude. Hey. Okay, fine. Don't listen to me. You know what? See if I care. Ugh. Jeez. Stubborn treasure chest. Okay, so, yeah, I've made some pretty powerful tools. Hello. wonderful. Okay, so... here's what I'm gonna do. I'm going to slaughter the skeleton, go in here, and hit the bed, because it's night. And you know what? I'm thinking this might be nearly the end of this episode, and I didn't get nearly as much accomplished as I thought I did, but now I've been doing this for a while, and it is just about time, honestly, to move on. So, which is kind of disappointing, but hey, you know, sometimes you just... gotta do what you gotta do. So, I will be back again next Wednesday, at the latest, with yet another episode of Let's Play Mindscape. Although, hopefully I can get one out in the intervening time period. Hopefully I can get another one out before then, and you don't have to wait until Wednesday, but no guarantees. It all depends on exactly how everything goes with life and such. So, yeah, let's see here. You know what? Where is the thing? Oh, hey, look, miniature red hearts. I've got a couple of those now. There's a thing that I'm looking for in here somewhere. Where is it? Oh, this guy. Weak infusion stone. I've got some things that I can combine with said weak infusion stone that should allow me to do something pretty cool. Let's see here. Let's grab some fire essence. Yeah. Okay, so if I open up the crafting table, I surround this with various level 1 essences, like this, and like this, and like this, I'll get a regular infusion stone. Now, the other thing that the Infusion Stone does, which I haven't really mentioned, is that I can take this, and of course, I mean, many of you probably know this already, but I can take the Weak Infusion Stone and Manichio Essence and upgrade it to Accio Essence. Then this Accio Essence can be used for, I keep saying Manichio, and I know it's Manicio because I looked up the mod creator's final word on the subject, but I can use this Manicio Essence, or this new Accio Essence, yeah, that's right, to make various things. I can make a furnace or a seed bag. I can make a block or coal seeds, dye seeds, water seeds, fire seeds, earth seeds, air seeds, Accio ingots. I can turn a diamond hoe into an Accio hoe. I can make an Accio pickaxe or shovel or sword. Rubber seeds, although I guess there must be rubber. Ball of glue, huh? Okay, can the rubber essence be really used for anything? It can make more balls of glue. That's kind of neat. What are those useful for? Oh, they act like slime balls. Okay, so I guess I can grow, like, cheap replacements for slime balls like that, which is kind of cool, maybe. Hey, I just saw a creeper outside. But the other thing that I can do with that is I can take this infusion stone, the regular infusion stone, and I can upgrade the Accio Essence to Crucio Essence, which I don't really want to do right now. So I just wanted to get that done before I forgot about it. Although one thing that I definitely want to do is pick up my furnace here. There we are. And take my furnace and feed it some Accio Essence like this. There we are. And you'll see that's actually part of a quest that I've got somewhere in here. Newbie quests. Farming level 15. Regular Infusion Stone, Accio Furnace, and Accio Hoe. So what we're going to do is actually I'm going to take my two diamonds that I've got left and some sticks here. And we're going to make a diamond a hoe. And a wise man once told me you should never waste your diamonds on a hoe. But in this particular scenario, it is justified. So there we have it. I've made an Accio hoe, and basically it gives you one extra Manicio essence whenever you harvest Manicio crops. And also this Accio furnace here, it's just like a regular furnace, except it works more quickly. So for example, if I put something in there that burns, which I don't really have anything right now that I want to do that with. But if I put something in there that I could cook, I think it does like 16 or something at once. It's not bad at all, actually. So, yeah, pretty cool stuff. And then I can take my hoe here and harvest some of these Manicio crops. Manicio. And those, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4. How many was that? Anyways, as you can see, I got 9 seeds back, and I probably got more essence than that because I got 2 essence for every plant as opposed to 1, and I just accidentally did this. But I'm not gonna use the hoe to till my land. I'm gonna use this, the final hoe, the Zvicio hoe. It is actually unbreakable. It does not take durability damage, so that one at some point I may do something cool with. I've got some sheep essence. What level is the sheep essence? Now I know that these quests I have, I give these away, these cool things, regular infusion stone. So I might be able to make the next level of infusion stone soon, because I know I've got plenty of the sheep essence already. I've got a couple more sheep crops here, but they're not quite grown yet. But I can turn in this quest now. You'll see I get an Accio seed bag, a watering can, and a choice between a reward, 2 different reward bags, or a Manicio block. And 15 White Knight favor because it's a farming level 15. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to take this Manicio block because I can always use a little bit extra of that stuff. And you'll see that now I've got a watering can. The watering can is just lovely. It speeds the growth of plants. Oh, wait, I've got to fill it with water first. There we go. Maybe. Oh, you know what? I don't have... yeah, it's because I've got particle effects reduced so that you guys don't have to look at this thing all the time, but let's just go with some particles here. As you can see, I'm sprinkling water on my farmland, and my crops are growing rapidly, so which is pretty cool. I've got skeletons in the well. Do you guys see this? I've got wellitons. Wellitons. I'm ridiculous. Why would I even say such a thing? That's kind of like ridiculous, actually. Like, very ridiculous. But yeah, anyways, as you can see, I did that, and that happened, and my crops grew very quickly. So, and I know somewhere in one of these chests or one of these things that I carry with me, I've got some sheep essence. There we go. So I've got actually enough sheep essence, not just to actually, boom, do this upgrade right here. There we go. Perfect. And of course, the sheep essence can be used for other things, such as, oh, nothing? Wait a sec. Sheep essence can't be used for anything? No, that's not quite right. That's supposed to be usable for things. I'm a little confused. Shouldn't you be able to craft wool out of sheep essence for starters? Like, shapeless crafting? No. What? Are you kidding me right now? Okay. So, I guess in the next update, I'm gonna have to add more uses for sheep essence. I may even add special uses for it, although I'm not yet sure what those would be. But yeah, probably gonna have to do that. So in the meantime, do I have anything, any foods in here I can cook or whatever? I guess I've got some wheat. I guess I've got wheat out here that's ready to harvest too. So before I end the video, I can demonstrate how much faster this is. There we go. Are they shooting at me? Jeez. What a bunch of rude jerks. No, they're shooting at each other. Ha! Ha 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 ha. He killed the other one. Are you almost dead? Hey, hit me. Hey, hit me. Hey, kill yourself. Kill yourself with recoil. I'm begging you. Please strike me with your bow. Ouch. You know what? That's going to take too long. Let's just go back and do this other thing. Okay. So, yeah. I'm going to take this wheat and turn it into wheat flour. 15 wheat flour. So let's see how this works. As you can see, it's significantly faster than a regular furnace. And if you've been watching my Project Ozone Let's Play, then you'll probably know that already. But I just figured I'd put it out there for you to know. Now, fun fact, magical crops used to do something else. Instead of making better furnaces that used fuel more efficiently and smelt things faster, what magical crops used to have was magical coal, and the magical coal actually would, it was actually kind of like the more powerful coals from Project E, or Equivalent Exchange, or whatever you want to, whichever one you want to reference. But as you can see, I've already crafted more than 8 bread in here, smelted more than 8 bread, and it's barely halfway through the first coal. So you can do about 16 items per coal in here in the same amount of time it would take a regular furnace to do 8, and each progressive furnace gets better and better at processing materials. So as you can see here, I've got another quest here to upgrade this stuff to Crucio, which I don't have nearly enough Manicio essence yet to do. But in the near future, that's something that I'm going to make happen. Oh, and also you'll see this seed bag. That's pretty cool. It plants seeds in a 2x2 area. I don't really care about that, so we're just going to shove it in this chest. And yeah. So you know what, guys? I think that's it for today. Thank you so much for watching Mindscape. Let's see here. Bread. I'm going to make toast. I'm going to make half of that into toast. There we go. What else can I make bread into? You know what? Hang on. Give me just a sec, guys. We're gonna come up with something here. Let's see. Fish sandwich, chicken sandwich. Oh, you know what? Don't I have a quest where I have to craft some chicken sandwiches here? Like this one? Pumpkin bread and chicken sandwich? Yes, I do have a quest like that. So, 2 chicken sandwiches and 6 pumpkin bread. I've got 7 bread here. I think I might need another bread. There we go. Thanks, furnace. And it shoots off these like little flame particles, but it doesn't catch anything on fire. So just FYI. So yeah, let's see here. To make a chicken sandwich, I'm going to need chicken. And I am going to need some eggs. And there we go. And I'm also going to need this juicer. And I think maybe like a skillet. Do I need to make a skillet for that? Hang on, let's see here. Chicken. Chicken sandwich. Right here, this one. Yeah, it's just raw chicken and bread and mayo and a skillet. So, and I'm going to have to make that skillet. I don't have that. So, which is just a stick and 2 iron ingots, which is easy. Let's grab some iron here. There we go. And a stick. Do I have a stick? Or have I got to craft a stick? I've got to craft a stick. There we go. Okay, so let's do this. There we go. And boom, boom. I now have a skillet. I'm also going to need to take a juicer to a couple of my eggs here to make mayo. There we have it. And then we'll take the skillet and the mayo and some chicken and some bread, and that will make a chicken sandwich or 2. There we go. Which I now have completed in the quest. There we go. Let's deposit that there. And then I'm also going to want pumpkin bread. Let's see here. So pumpkin bread. Here we go. I need 6 of this stuff. So I'm not going to finish that today. But I can make the bakeware while I'm at it, which means I'm going to need some bricks. 8 bricks, which I can easily make. There we go. Okay. And I've got to figure out, do pumpkins only like grow on dirt or something? I don't really know how that works, but what I do know for sure is that I've had 2 fully grown pumpkin stalks outside for quite some time now. And oh, it's dark. I've had 2 fully grown pumpkin stalks outside for quite some time now, and they have not yet grown to capacity. So, they've not produced any pumpkins. So, I think what I'm gonna do is come over here and, like, do this. There we go. Ah! Oh, geez, you scared me, luggage. Okay, there we go. And, I don't know, let's try my watering can and see what happens. There we go. Is that skeleton still trying to shoot me from the well? Jeez. Okay, so pumpkin stems. I don't know if the watering can actually works on making pumpkin stems grow pumpkins faster. I see that it grew an azure blue A. Yeah, that's bizarre. Now, it's got a 3x3 area focused on the center block, whatever block you're... Ouch. You know what? You're dead, sucker. There's a chicken here. Okay, well, I'm just gonna have to wait for my pumpkins to grow, apparently. So yes. That's it for today, right? That's it? No more... There's nothing else I can do or make or say or do? Yeah, okay. So that is it for today, guys. Thanks so much for watching today's episode of Let's Play Mindscape. And I know it may not have been quite as exciting as some previous episodes, but I'm sure that you guys enjoyed it nonetheless. In the next episode, we're probably going to continue moving some things over to the new place and probably dig it a basement and things too, some other fun stuff, all sorts of cool things that I don't really have planned yet, but I've got a whole week to plan them and record, so yeah, I hope you guys are going to enjoy that stuff. For the most part, we're not going to move on into any more epic quests than we already have until I go to do Alfred Grimhand's World Tour, which I have appropriate armor for, but I really want to get some other quests out of the way first, because that's going to take probably several episodes, just as a guess. So yeah, thank you so much for watching, everybody, and I will catch you next time.